Assalamu alaikum viewers, welcome to Al Caliph TV. Let's have a look at today's news. Hundreds of AFD delegates will gather Saturday for a congress that authorities have warned could become a COVID-19 hotspot as the German far-right party increasingly aligns itself with activists protesting COVID-19 restrictions. 600 members of the anti-Muslim, anti-immigrant party are due to meet at an unused NuClear plant in Western Germany's Kalkar city to draw up their first concept on pensions. United States sanctions Chinese-Russian firms over Iran dealings. The United States on Friday announced economic sanctions on Chinese and Russian companies that Washington said had supported the development of Iran's missile program. The four firms accused of transferring sensitive technology and items to Iran's missile program will be subject to restrictions on U.S. government aid and on their exports for 2 years, Secretary of State Mike Pompeo said in a statement. The imposed sanctions were against two Chinese-based companies, namely Chengdu-based New Materials and Zibo Ilm Trade, as well as Russia-based Nilco Group and joint stock company Ilikon. Mike Pompeo further said, "We will continue to work to impede Iran's missile development efforts and use our sanctions authorities to spotlight the foreign suppliers, such as these entities and the PRC China and Russia that provide missile-related materials and technology to Iran." Former Honduran President Manuel Zelaya said on Friday that he had been unjustly detained at the Central American nation's Tocantins International Airport for carrying $18,000 in cash, which he said was not his. He further said to media that, "I don't know the origin of that money. Obviously, someone must have put it in my belongings. I have traveled 400 times and I know that you cannot travel with that amount of money. It's necessary to investigate who put that money in my belongings." Before that, earlier he wrote on Twitter that he had been unjustly detained. Iran has vowed to avenge the killing of its most senior nuclear scientist, Mohsin Fakhrizadeh, who has assassinated near Tehran on Friday. Fakhrizadeh died in hospital after an attack in absurd and demoned country. Hossein Dehghan, military advisor to Supreme Leader Ayatollah Ali Khamenei, vowed to strike the perpetrators like thunder. Western intelligence agencies believe Fakhrizadeh was behind a covert Iranian nuclear weapons program. Iran insists its nuclear program is for peaceful purposes. The country's foreign minister Mohammad Javad Zarif called on the international community to condemn this act of state terror. Ethiopia's military claims it has seized control of several towns in the northern region of Tigray. The army has been locked in conflict with the Tigray People's Liberation Front (TPLF) for weeks. Lieutenant General Hassan Ibrahim said the army had captured Vekro, north of the Tigrayan capital Mekelle, along with several other towns. He further said that it comes a day after the government said it was beginning the final phase of an offensive in the region. These were some important news of the day. Thank you for watching Al Caliph TV.